Hi everybody, this is Jennifer with Choice Slides, and in today's Create It tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create this magnifying glass effect. Now this has been a request from several different customers of mine trying to recreate this in Photopia. Two caveats to this tutorial. This uses the follow filter, which means the way I'm going to create this in this tutorial can only be done in Photopia Director and ProShow Producer version 9 because it uses the follow filter. Now, if you're using an earlier version of ProShow or you have Photopia Creator, you can still create this effect, but the way this works is there's a mask that is following our magnifying glass using the follow filter. You don't have the follow filter, but that doesn't mean you can't do this. You would just have to manually place keyframes so that your mask follows your magnifying glass. So you can still do this in Creator or an earlier version of Producer. You're just gonna have to take a few extra steps. So the first thing that you're going to need is obviously a magnifying glass. If you come to pixabay.com, and in the search bar, type in magnifying glass and change the drop down to vector graphics. You actually have several good options down here. I happen to choose this one. I kind of like the fact that it had kind of a light blue outside, but there are several magnifying glasses. Just make sure whatever magnifying glass you choose, when you click on it, that you see this checkerboard background. That means that it's a PNG and not a JPEG, and you can actually see through to the image behind. So this is the magnifying glass I chose. So go ahead and download that. Okay, before we add that magnifying glass to a slide, you need to find a very specific image for this effect to work. So for those of you who want to, you know, zoom into a part of an image, I'm kind of assuming maybe there's a bunch of people in your photo and you want to, you know, magnify individual people. So the way that this effect works is there are two layers of that exact image, and the layer that's underneath the magnifying glass is zoomed in pretty far. So the only way that this works really well is if you have a photo with whatever you want to zoom in, but you have to be able to zoom in and still have everyone in the frame. So if you have an image like this one, where the faces are all the way to the edge and you want to zoom in, this one's probably not gonna be that great because you're cutting off the faces of the people on the side. So this effect really only works with very specific images where there's plenty of room to zoom in for that duplicated layer and still be able to see everybody. So I have my photo. So what you need to do is take a few minutes and find a photo that maybe has a lot of people in it, but still has plenty of room around the outside. Once you have that image in a slide, just go ahead and duplicate it. And then the top one, just zoom in. And it's okay if you reposition this, by the way, because when something gets zoomed in, you know, the position and the zoom are a little bit off of the original, and that's okay. So zoom this in just as far as you can. This is the top image. Zoom it in so that everybody's still in frame, but clearly bigger than the original. Okay, then go ahead and add your magnifying glass. And we're going to add a masking layer above the image that you've zoomed in, but in ProShow, I believe you can make that follow your masking, your magnifying glass, no matter what order you do this in. In Director, you actually have to do this in a very specific order or it won't work. So the masking layer is going to be a circle. And we're gonna, for me, I liked it to be a little bit of a gradient so that the edge is not quite perfectly circular, but you can do that in any way you want. So we're not going to add a masking layer just yet in Director. We're going to add a gradient, then turn it into a mask after we've added the follow filter. This has to be done in a specific order or it won't work. So I have my top image, the one that's kind of zoomed in selected. We're going to add that gradient above that. So then hit add, add gradient, make your gradient a radial, and we need to have white on the inside and black on the outside because white reveals and black conceals. and then bring the white in and the black in, and you kind of don't want to see it touching, you don't want to see the white touching the edge at all. And how tight this circle is completely up to you. In Director, we can even cut this into a shape of a circle. Then you may have to go in and change this to make sure that it fits right. So we'll just do that real quick. In Producer, you can do this exactly as I just did, but then go into your vignette settings to cut it into a circle. So this could be done in different ways. In Director, select that gradient, come over to your Layer tab, and then for Shape, go down to Basic Shapes and click Circle. And so I might need to go back in and change my gradient. This looks okay, but I do think I want the white to go a little bit further to the edge. So I'll right click, choose Edit Change, and I'm just gonna bring that white out a little bit, maybe the black out just a little bit. And you can tweak this as much as you want to get it the circle just right. Now leave that gradient right in the middle of the screen. This is important in both programs for the follow filter. You don't want to move it with just here in the preview. You want to move it using the follow filter. So in both ProShow and Director, add a follow filter. In Director, it's under the Effects tab. In ProShow, it's under the Filters tab. And add a follow filter to the gradient layer. Bring your target drop-down menu so that it is following the magnifying glass, and make it follow position and zoom. Now in ProShow, I believe right there in that window, you can just rescale it and move it and all of the attributes will follow. That's not true in Director. You're gonna have to use these drop-down menus here to move your gradient over and up and zoom it down. And just try and get it to match your magnifying glass as best you can. And then if you want to test the follow filter, grab your magnifying glass and just move it around. And you'll see that the gradient is following it perfectly. So now that we have the follow filter following the magnifying glass, all you need to do is select that gradient layer, right click on it, and choose Use as Masking Layer, and it will mask the larger image right behind it, but not the smaller image. So now when we move the magnifying glass, it's magnifying the larger image that's beneath it, and it's not masking out the smaller image behind it. So for ProShow and Director users, now all you would need to do is come into your Animations tab, or in ProShow, the Effects tab, and for the magnifying glass only, set keyframes for its position, and it will travel across your screen like that. So for creator users, you're pretty much gonna follow the same concept, but since you don't have the follow filter, you'll have your two layers, your masking layer and your magnifying glass. Move your magnifying glass across the screen how you want it, and then just, you'll have to take your gradient layer that's a mask and kind of match the keyframes as best you can. So this effect can be done in Creator. It's just not as easy. And if you make any changes, you're going to have to make changes to both the magnifying glass layer and your gradient layer. One other note, the follow filter, I've mentioned several times that the follow filter isn't as good as groups. And it depends on what you're doing. So in this case, we could not have turned this into a group in Director because the masking layer literally has the zoomed in image attached to it. And if we put this into a group, that bottom layer that's big would actually move with the magnifying glass, defeating the purpose. So we could not have used a group with this, or it would have, the back layer would have moved with the magnifying glass. So we can only use the follow filter with this. The problem with the follow filter in both programs is zoom does not work. It never has. So if you try to zoom your magnifying glass in, look what happens to the mask. It gets offset. It does not work. So before you animate your mask and your magnifying glass, make sure it's a size that you want it to be, because you don't want to animate the size, the scale of this, because the follow filter does not work that way. So make sure you've got your size right, and then you can just animate it across your photo, and that is how the magnifying glass effect is done. Thank you so much for watching and for allowing me to help you unleash your creativity.